Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Top 5 Army. Today, we are going to be talking about 10 of artists' albums that have flopped recently. Before we start, I want you to hit that red subscribe button so that you never miss out on any of our videos. Now let's get right into it. At number 1, we have Confessions of a Dangerous Mind by Logic. This is the rapper's 5th studio album, and he previously had a hit, 1-800-273-8255, and he had 2 Grammy nominations last year. But his new album, Confessions of a Dangerous Mind, had received aggressively mixed reviews. Variety's review actually said that the music was complex, celestial, and snaky, but Hip Hop DX described it as dangerously corny, pity party of epic proportions. At number 2, we have Save Me by Future. This is the acclaimed rapper's 2nd EP of 2019, and everyone described it as a hit or miss. Pitchfork Reads Jackson wrote, "His latest EP proves he's still a master of melancholic detail, but thematically and sonically, the Atlanta superstar has hit a wall." At number 3, we have Wasteland Baby by Hozier. Hozier released this album for the first time in 5 years. He had previously released a single called Take Me to Church, which was an extremely successful song, but unfortunately many critics had agreed that it failed to live up to the high expectations that Take Me to Church set. At number 4, we have Love and Fear by Marina. Marina was formerly known as Marina and the Diamond, and she has recently released her 4th studio album called Love and Fear. Unfortunately, a critic had written that Marina, the lyricist who wasn't afraid to detail the taste of toothpaste on a lover's tongue, the vocalist who wasn't afraid to punctuate a sentence with a feral shriek, has gone missing. Someone also wrote, "The temptation of safe is undeniable, but mononyms are earned by embracing risks." At number 5, we have Labyrinth, Sia, and Diplo present LSD, which was made by Labyrinth, Sia, and Diplo. This trio actually thought that the album would be a huge hit, but unfortunately, a critic wrote, "An album of truly forgettable pop music that is too tired to be wired." At number 6, we have Father of Assad by DJ Khaled. This is DJ Khaled's 11th studio album, which is insane. He has had a lot of songs featuring many different artists that many other artists would dream to collab with. But unfortunately, his album Father of Assad actually failed to even debut at number 1 on the Billboard 200. Critics called it lazy and adequate, and there are plenty of voices but no clear message or intention. At number 7, we have The Lost Tapes 2 by Nas. Nas was extremely thrilled and celebrated this album, but unfortunately critics had wrote that the album seems a tad pointless and something that won't really captivate many beyond his hardcore fanbase. At number 8, we have Free Spirit by Khaled. Unfortunately, critics had written about this album that on Free Spirit, Khaled sounds caught between wanting to play a superstar and wanting to be himself, with the result that he sounds like neither. At number 9, we have Can't Say I Ain't Country by Florida Georgia Line. Unfortunately, critics wrote about this album that said, "For all the shopping mall feel of their songs, they can be industrially catchy, if only their lyrics weren't so cringy." We actually sort of feel bad about this one. And finally, at number 10, we have Number 6 Collaborations Project by Ed Sheeran. Critics had written about this album that few releases have been as baldly transparent and destined for ubiquity as Number 6. Which has all the conspicuous mining of a Drake album but very little of the finesse or cultural fluency. This brings us to the end of our video. I hope you enjoyed it. Hit like if you did and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any of our videos in the future. Also, watch the 2 videos that are on your screen because I'm sure you'll love them. And with that, I'll see you in the next video.